Let's go straight to the calculation involving Boyle's law. Having seen what Boyle's law is and the formula, is P1 V1 is equals to P2 V2. The first question, a sample of gas occupies 12 liter under a pressure of 1.2 atmosphere. What will its volume be if the pressure were increased to 2.4 atmosphere? Solution, whenever you are given calculation in any subject, the first thing first is to bring out your parameters. Your parameters are your information that are given in the question. They said a sample of gas occupies 12 liter. That is the volume. Remember, I told you that 1 liter is equivalent to 1 centimeter cube. So in case you don't see centimeter cube, you will see liter. You are still talking about the volume. So the first volume in that question, that is the initial volume, V1, is equal to 12 liter. Under a pressure of 1.2 atmosphere. Remember, I told you that 1 atmosphere again, which is still a unit of pressure, is what? Equivalent to millimeter mercury. So we are seeing this working its own value, the same quantity pressure. So the first pressure there, P1, is equal to 1.2 atmosphere. What will its volume be? What will its volume be? That is the second or the final volume, V2. What will the volume be? Question mark. We don't know. If the pressure were increased to 2.4 atmosphere, that is the final pressure, P2, the final pressure, and we have 2.4 atmosphere. You can see there's no temperature given here. In another word, the temperature is constant. That's what Boyle's law is trying to say. So having bring out your parameter without even being told which law to use, what should pop in your mind is that Boyle's law is coming to play here. And what does the law state? So according to Boyle's law, you know that P1 V1 goes to P2 V2. Now, what's P1? P1 there is 1.2. Mind you, there's an invisible times here. Don't forget. 1.2 times the V1, 12, goes to P2, 2.4 times your V2 unknown. We don't know. How do you simplify this simple math? You bring up your calculator and you multiply 1.2 multiply by 12. Let's work with the calculator now. 1.2 multiply by 12, that's 14.4, is equals to 2.4 times V2, will give us 2.4 V2. How do you do this? You get V2, divide both sides by 2.4, here also by 2.4. 2.4 we cancel 2.4, leaving you with only V2. V2 is equals to 14.4 over 2.4. You bring up your calculator again. We divide 14.4 divided by 2.4 and we have 6. So our final volume, V2, is 6 watts. What is the unit of volume? I told you units is very, very important when you are solving anything involving science. 6 liter. So you can see when the pressure is 2.4 lesser or higher pressure, we have a smaller volume, 6 liter, compare this pressure to this one. So as you see, when the pressure is increasing, the volume will decrease. 6 liter, you are correct. When the pressure is decreasing, the volume will increase, 12 liter. That's what Boyle is trying to say. The volume of a fixed mass of gas is inversely proportional to the pressure, provided the temperature remains constant. This is a good and typical illustration or example of Boyle's law. We'll look at more questions to clarify this law. The next law that governs gases is known as Charles' law. We have looked at Boyle's law and we have stated it. We have seen a good example. The other law we're looking at now is known as Charles' law. What does Charles' law state? It states that the volume of a fixed mass of gas is directly proportional, unlike Boyle's law, that is inversely proportional. This time around, the volume of a fixed mass of gas is proportional to the temperature, not pressure. This time around, temperature, provided the pressure remains constant. The volume of a fixed mass of gas is directly proportional to the temperature, provided what remains constant, provided the pressure remains constant. This time around, you are keeping pressure constant, and the volume of a fixed mass is directly proportional to the temperature. That is, if you increase the volume, the temperature will increase. If you decrease the volume, the temperature will also decrease. Mathematically, what are we saying? We are saying that V is directly proportional to temperature. This is the sign of proportionality. If you remove that sign and put equal to, you introduce a constant K, T. Where that K here is the pressure that is constant, as we have said. Make K, so with a formula, that means V equals to KT divided by T, divided by T. Then we have K is V over T. Now, when we have two conditions, both the initial and the final, as we have said, then what will Chasse law give us? Chasse law, we have what now? V1 over T1 equals to V2 over T2. So this is Chasse law, equation 2. As I have said earlier on, learn how to derive formulas. When we look at more calculation in chemistry, we're looking at how to derive formula. Once you know how to derive a formula, you can always know your calculation very well in chemistry. Calculation in chemistry is very, very interesting and very, very easy. This is equation 2. V1 over T1 equals to V2 over T2. That's what Chasse law is trying to say. So having seen what Chasse law is all about, that the volume of a given mass of gas is directly proportional to its temperature, provided that the pressure remains constant, and the formula is V1 over T1 is equal to V2 over T2. In other words, where V1 is our initial volume measured in centimeter cube, T1, please always try to define your formula whenever you are stating or writing it, because the person that is reading it will be confused. It can be anything. T1 is the initial temperature. This temperature here must be Kelvin. But once or you are given in degree Celsius, you can always convert to Kelvin. We are going to look at how to convert that. And V2 equals to final volume measured in centimeter cube, and T2 is the final temperature measured in Kelvin as well. So how do you convert degree Celsius, T degree Celsius, to Kelvin? Now, to convert degree Celsius to Kelvin, it is given as T Kelvin, TK, is 273 plus T degree Celsius. In other words, if you are given 23 degrees Celsius and you are asked to convert it to Kelvin, you add 273 to it. That means T Kelvin becomes 273 plus 23. And what would that give us? TK becomes what? 296 Kelvin. Please take note of this conversion. Whenever you are given calculation in Chasse law and your temperature is in degree Celsius, please always convert to Kelvin. If you do not convert to Kelvin, you will not get the right answer. But if you are given in Kelvin, no problem. Work straight with that parameter you are given. Now, the graphical representation of Chasse law, we are seeing that the volume is directly proportional to the temperature. And in other words, if you are increasing the volume, what do you expect the temperature to do? Temperature, you are expecting temperature to what? Increase. But if you are decreasing the volume, you are expecting temperature to also what? Drop as well. Now, this is what we're talking about. Let's say here is 0, here is 1, here is 2, here is 3, and here is 4. So, as the volume is increasing, your temperature is also increasing. You can see they are increasing. So, if here is 1, here is 2, here is 3, here is 4, and here the time will be 2, let's say 2 degrees Celsius, 4 degrees Celsius, 6 and 8. So as the volume is increasing, the temperature is increasing. Minus 273 degrees Celsius is the absolute temperature. We call it the absolute temperature. at absolute temperature, the state of matter, they are in a state of constant rest. That temperature is known as absolute temperature, and the value is given as -273°C. So we'll look at examples to illustrate and understand this law, just as we did for Boyle's law.